In this lesson, we will explore how to render a still image using Enscape, and what settings could be the most interesting for you while doing so. To render an image using Enscape is really simple. Just press this button up here, or press the hotkey, which is Shift and F11 by default. Enscape will ask you where you would like to save the image and will render it right away. Done. So, to have something to tell you in this lesson, let's go over some more details and settings that you might want to use to set up an image. First, the resolution. You can change it in the Visual Settings, Output tab. If you don't know what resolution to go with, leave it at default. Full HD is perfectly fine in most cases. If you'd like to print it on a larger scale, you can also go with Ultra HD or higher values, but if your graphics card runs out of available memory, Enscape may crash during rendering. When selecting Custom as a resolution, you can choose the aspect ratio of your export freely. In this case, it is recommended to enable the save frame in the Enscape interface so you are always aware of the perspective of the resulting image. If you'd like to change the hotkey to render an image to any other combination, you can do so in the Renderer Window Settings Input tab. In the Output tab, you can also set up a default folder, in case you don't want to be prompted to choose a location every time. And you can tell Enscape to name the rendering automatically. You can choose the default file type and, if you want to post-process your rendering, you can enable Export Object ID, Material ID and Depth Channel to export not one, but four images, enabling you to edit any elements of your rendering separately in a 2D software if required. Tip: if you want to export an alpha channel, meaning a black and white mask for your rendering to add a custom background, enable Export Object ID, Material ID and Depth Channel, and dial the depth range all the way up to 10,000 meters. You'll receive a map you can use to easily replace the background.